Hello and welcome to all the viewers. In this video, we will talk about ANSI's capabilities as well as types of ANSI's license. So this video is useful for ANSI's users, service providers as well as students which are doing their last year project or you can say the curriculum project in the analysis domain. So as we know that there are different or variety of ANSI's products are available in the market, but it is difficult to select the right product. For them, we have created this video. So you can go through that and here we will discuss what are the variety of ANSI's product for structure domain, as well as we will discuss about the what are the short forms and what are the major ANSI's licenses. Then we will start now. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. So as discussed earlier, we will first see what are the types or products of ANSI's. Then we'll see what are the major products for structure domain. Then ANSI's 2019 R1 capabilities as well as ANSI's 19 capabilities. ANSI's license short forms which are useful while selecting the particular license. So now I am in the ANSI's portal. So if you see here, you just need to type ANSI's.com and there you can see the products. So when you see the products, there are different variety of products are available. So you can segregate that by view by products by physics or in all products you can see. Okay, so let's talk about the products by physics, and here we will see what are the major products are used for structure domain. As we know that in most of the markets the structure simulations are performed. So when you click on the structure, you will find there are a variety of ANSI's products are available, like ANSI's ACT, ANSI's additive prints, additive suits, aqua, autodyne, LS Dyna, mechanical, mechanical premium, mechanical pro, motion. So like these are the different variety of ANSI's license are available. So you just need to go through the description and based on that you will come to know what are this license useful, or you can say the applications of this respective licenses. As we know that ANSI's mechanical, I think most of the ANSI's user know this ANSI's mechanical. So now this is what the one of the flagship product of ANSI's. So it is, that's why they call as a flagship tool for finite element analysis. So ANSI's Mechanical Enterprises is the flagship mechanical engineering software solution that uses FEA for structural analysis using the ANSI's Mechanical Interface. So it covers an enormous range of applications. So when we talk about enormous, so there are wide range of applications will come into picture. So you will find that comes with complete everything you need from geometry preparation to optimization. So basically they are saying that when you receive the products from 2D to 3D, you can create with the help of geometry, and then if you want to do optimization, that can also be done with the help of ANSI's mechanical. So with mechanical enterprises, you can model advanced materials, complex environmental loadings, industry specific requirements such as offshore hydrodynamics as well as layer composite materials. And you can see these material dynamics as well as additional values are useful, like ANSI's extensions we can download and we can use that with the help of ANSI's mechanical. And when we talk about capabilities, like it is useful for nonlinear capabilities, dynamics, and it will come with the ANSI's space claim, also used for multi-physics, composites, optimization. There are more things like customization and hydrodynamics. So this is the major one which most of the ANSI's users or service providers are have. This is ANSI's mechanical. The next one is like less further structure. The next major is like ANSI's mechanical premium and ANSI's mechanical professional. So when we talk about ANSI's mechanical premium, it is like advanced non-linear stress simulations and comprehensive linear dynamics. So it uses the ANSI's mechanical interface to deliver powerful finite element modeling capabilities in the way you can use to make the real structural engineering decisions. So mechanical premium give you access to mechanical solver with incredible scale. You can see scalability, wide industry adoption, super support from broad base of engineers around the globe. So basically it involves like linear dynamics, non-linearities, mechanisms, as well as thermal modeling. So when you came into picture, like you need to do different linear dynamics simulations. So in that case, you can go with this ANSYS mechanical premium, as well as if your structure have different mechanical non-linearities like geometry, contact, as well as material non-linearity. So you can find over here, which is useful, like materials like rubber as well as neoprene. And also it is useful for a thermal modeling. Okay, so you can go through this portal, then you will come to know the like different capabilities. If you click on this, then you will see what are the detailed description for that. Okay, then next I will just go through the short forms, and I will not go in much depth. You just visit this website and there you will come to know the differences for each and every licenses. Then next, talk about the ANSYS Mechanical Pro. So it is basically simulate the mechanical behavior of a material in real world conditions. Okay, so this all three, like ANSYS Mechanical Premium and Pro, are similar one, but you will find in ANSYS Mechanical is widely used, while ANSYS Premium is like thermal modeling, non-linear capabilities. So in that case, that is more useful. Now we can see here, like ANSYS Mechanical Pro adds more features like capability in ANSYS design space. So that is what the advantage of this. It has same user interface as design space, resulting in fast learning experience as well as greater productivity for regular or occasional users. Okay, so you can find like compact contact capabilities as well as fatigue analysis as well as large deflections. So basically it is useful for a fatigue types of loadings. Compact capabilities as well as large deflections are involved. Okay, so you can see here like they have given high performance computing, geometric non-linearity, fatigue module, contact capabilities, multi-physics as well as thermal analysis. So you just have a look over this and then you will come to know the what are the exact features of this. Okay, now these are the three major licenses which are useful for your ANSYS. Now next, talk about I think we might aware of there are few ACT like extensions are available. So what exactly it is? When we talk about structure, then you will find ANSYS ACT. So what exactly it is? So it is basically the fastest and easiest way to tailor your simulations workflow. As we have seen, the extensions like math creations, when we talk about pressure vessels, like optimization extensions are there. So this all you will find in ANSYS ACT. So it is the basically a configuring simulation application to fit your engineering workflows in a complex as well as time consuming. So ACT basically simplifies this process so you can focus more on engineering products. That basically it is used for a customization software. Okay, and it uses basically a powerful XML or Python programming languages that enable your non-expert user to create a custom applications of their advanced workflows. You can have a look on that and then you will come to know what exactly it is. So like it extends your simulation functionality, compares your simulation process, customize your workflows, and also you can integrate the third party tools data like your external programs data, define custom solvers, add new optimization algorithm, and also like explore shares and sales applications. So it is basically a develops as well as customize the software. Okay, now let's talk about the other major license, like the next one you will say this ANSYS Autodyne. So basically if you see on the products, there are two major suits. If you click on further structure, you will find here this ANSYS Encode is basically for a fatigue. Here ANSYS Autodyne and ANSYS LS Dyna. So both are like useful for short period endurance simulations. Let's talk about some description. So it is useful to simulate short duration as well as saver loadings. So it's used to simulate the response of a material to short durations, saver loadings from impact, high pressure as well as explosions. So it is the best suited for simulating large material deformation failure, and it provides advanced solutions methods without compromising easier use. So basically it is used when you will find these interactions like liquid, solid, gases as well as phase transitions of materials. As well as we saw that propagation of shock waves, in that case this Autodyne is useful. So integrated with ANSYS Workbench with its own native user interface. So this program has the for decades led the industry use. Okay. Now when we talk about capabilities like solver technology, solver coupling, material data, you can go through this, then you will come to know the what exact this Autodyne used to do. So it range technologies means that you can model solid with Lagrangian elements, liquid with Eulerian, as well as smooth particle heterodynamics. Okay. So basically it is used to simulate the short duration as well as saver loading, as well as different liquid interfaces, gases, phase interfaces, as well as phase changes. Now let's talk about ANSYS LS-DYNA. I think this is also most of the users know what exactly it does. So ANSYS LS-DYNA is most commonly used for explicit simulations. So I think you might have seen like car crash and all the simulations are to be done with the help of ANSYS LS-DYNA. So capable of simulating the response of a material for short periods, saver loadings. It many elements, contact formulations, material models and other controls can be used to simulate the complex model with control over all the details of the problem. So basically, when we talk about capabilities, it is non-linear structural analysis, ANSYS workbench integrations, element as well as contact combinations are useful. So it has vast array of capabilities to simulate the extreme deformation problems using its explicit solver. Nowadays, there are most of the service providers as well as manufacturers are using explicit simulations for like mobile drop, your cylinder drop, gas cylinder impact. So in that case, this ANSYS LS-DYNA is very useful to perform the explicit simulations. Okay. So basically it can tackle the simulations involving material failure, look at how the fatigue process through a part of through a systems. So I will not going to read each and every, you just have a look on this, then you will come to know the exact differences. So at present, the purpose of this video, just you should know where, what are the different ANSYS mechanical products. Based on the these products, you can select your simulation or vice versa. Okay. Now here, there are few other softwares, or you can see the TRIPS are available, ANSYS Motions, basically used for multi-body dynamics. Then ANSYS ENCODE, as we know that it is basically used to perform the fatigue simulations. Let's discuss this also, like it's used to predict your product's failure life before you build it. So basically it is used for a fatigue analysis process. And let's talk about like design space licenses. This is what one of the best solver, or you can say one of the best ANSYS license, ANSYS Discovery AM. So I will show you what exactly it is. So like it is useful to solve the multi-physics simulations within the single user interface. It combines intuitions, guided workflows, accurate simulation results as well as optimizations. So it is, you can go through this video, you will come to know this. And there is another like ANSYS Discovery, I think now it came new into picture. So it basically works on the GPU, graphics process unit. I will create a separate video on this ANSYS Discovery because it is very useful for a designers. It will give you within a short period of time, you can easily find out, like if you are doing model analysis within a few seconds, you can see what are the mode shapes. If you are doing any design changes or optimization, you can find within a few seconds with the help of this ANSYS Discovery Live software. So basically it instantaneous 3D simulations. So you can see here itself with direct geometry modeling for interactive design exploration, rapid product innovations. So you can easily manipulate geometry, material types, physics. So here there is no need to, suppose if your product is failing, then you, what the process design life cycle is like, you need to give to analyst. Then he used to do meshing, then he used to do different design iterations. But the advantage of Ansys Discovery Live that within a short period of time, that manufacturer, or you can say the designer itself, find what are the mode shapes or what are the design changes he needs to do within a few seconds of time. So no need to do the meshing. It can directly give you an instantaneous 3D design results. So that's why it is very useful. Okay. And I think we know this Ansys Design Space Claim, which is basically a 3D CAD interface, which is useful for a modeling. Okay. And now there are different platforms which are useful to solve these simulations. I think we most know this Ansys Performance Computing. So basically HPC license, if you see, it is basically the multi-core computers which are used to solve your simulations. Okay. Now there are different solvers, or you can say the products are available based on the physics. You can see these electromagnetics, the, as well as embedded softwares, fluids are there, Ansys CFX, Blade Modeler. Okay. Now you just have a look on this, and based on your applications, you can select the respective products. In structure, as we discussed, we most familiar with Ansys Mechanical, Mechanical Premium or Pro. Ansys Mechanical is most widely used, and there are in addition to that, you might have seen Ansys Prepost, basically used for a pre-processing applications. So in pre-processing, like you can do all meshing, you can do geometry editing in Design Modeler or Space Claim, meshing, contact definitions, loading, all these things you can do in pre-post. So most of the service provider also have the pre-post license with them. Now there are two more licenses are there, like when we talk about NLT and NLS, they are the two licenses. So Ansys Professional NLS, I think the name itself says that NLS means non-linear structural. It gives you access to much Ansys non-linear capabilities. So this include non-linear contact with constant friction, bilinear plasticity, large deflections. You can also do the steady state thermal with this license and use results as a load in structural analysis. So basically it is used for non-linear structural simulation. Now what about NLT? You will also find this license or this product. So NLT means non-linear thermal. It gives access to steady state and transient thermal analysis. You can also perform structural analysis with limited access to non-linear capabilities. Transient thermal analysis means that you can analyze temperature over time, so the heating and cooling of the structure can be analyzed. So the analysis is carried out over several time period, and each steps can be linked with the structural analysis. So basically NLS is used for frictional, non-linear, bilinear plasticity, but here in NLT you can't solve the frictional simulations, you can't solve the non-linear contacts. So for that you need to go with NLS software. Okay. So these are the two major, pre-post, Ansys Mechanical. Okay. Like this you will have the combinations for a structural domain, and for electronics or embedded, for others you can find from the portal. Now there is one question will come into your mind, like we have seen the description, but after having all this, if suppose I need to do the spring modeling, I need to do the non-linear contact, so which license I should select? So these questions will come into your mind. So when you put Google, like Ansys capabilities, 19 capabilities, 2019 capabilities, you will find this PDF, and this PDF will demonstrate the license and as well as different your operations. Like when we talk about structure, geometry idealization, so here you will find for a spring, mass, damp, sparse, these are the our pre-processing operations. So for all these creations you can find these are the Ansys products. Now Ansys Mechanical, as we discussed, it is widely used and it is useful most for all the modeling as well as geometric idealization capabilities. While Mechanical Premium you will find is not useful for structuring. Similarly, Mechanical Pro is not useful for infinite domain, 2.5 reinforcement, as well as substructuring and matrix. Similarly, you will find Design Space and ANSYS Autodyne, LS Dyna, ANSYS AIM. Okay, so this is all about your geometry modeling, but what about contacts? So like linear contacts and non-linear. So all this Premium Pro and Mechanical is useful, but as well as this ANSYS Dyna, Auto, LS Dyna as well as AIM is also used for contact modeling. But there are few things, like when we talk about spot weld, when we talk about element birth and death, it is useful for weld simulations as well as gasket. So for this, only Mechanical is useful, but ANSYS Pro as well as ANSYS Premium and ANSYS LS Dyna, all these licenses are not useful. Okay, so like that, you can go through this PDF and you will come to know the exact differences or capabilities for each and every licenses. Now let's talk about material also, like linear materials. You will find for linear materials, I think all modules are suitable. But when we talk about non-linear materials, only Mechanical Premium and your ANSYS Mechanical is useful. As well as you will find there are two other things like LS Dyna and Autodyne. Because in explicit, there is chances of non-linearity, and both of these are useful for explicit simulations. Now you will also find like submodelings, data mapping, trace mapping, and topology optimizations. There also you will find all four from ANSYS Design Phase to ANSYS Mechanical. Now we can go through vibrations. These are also like structural topology, multi-analysis, vibration, like for model, pre-stress model, all first fours are useful. But when we talk about damp and unsymmetric transient, then only Mechanical Premium and Mechanical is useful. Remaining all other not useful for that. So you just go through this and there you will come to know the exact differences. I think here like you will find from pre-processing to post-processing, the different ANSYS simulation physics. Based on that, which license I need to select or you need to select, you can easily figure out. Okay, so as we discussed, Mechanical is useful for explicit, but this ANSYS Autodyne and LS Dyna is especially made for explicit simulations. And here you will find this rectangular kind of symbol. So it means that if you see here, is you will find the differences like fully supported triangle is limited capabilities, requires more than one product. So it is demonstrated, is given for each and everything. Now for thermal as well as additional physics, hydrodynamics are there. Okay, like miscellaneous capabilities, space claim, and all other also you will find, as well as HPC, high performance computer, also you can find how we can link with that. Now next one is like ANSYS CFD, also you will find within the same. Now let's see the other capabilities, like talk about. So here this 2019 R1 capabilities, here also you will easily figure out for structure, fluid, electronics, design tools, additives, all these physics, what license you need to select. Okay, it is more or less same to what we discussed on 2019. So for each version you have capability kind of PDF, so you just have a look on this and then you will clear all the doubts about ANSYS products. Now there is one more thing, like the short forms which are used when used to ANSYS user. So these are the short forms. When you see, suppose you have some ANSYS Mechanical or Design Explorer and you are using that, or it is suppose it's locked in your system, then how to figure out which is license? Because in ANSYS capability or ANSYS license client and ANSYS admin utility, you will not find this full form, you will find only a short forms. So when we talk about design modeler, you will find a short form of AGPPI, like ANSYS Design Explorer DSDXMEM. Now when you have geometry interface license, you will have CATIA V5, like PICATV5. Similarly, you have for PROE, PI, PRIOE, SOLIDWORKS, PI, SOLO, LWOR. Now, next talk about ANSYS Mechanical Pre-Post. You will find Pre-Post like meshing, you will find a mesh, design space, you will find a CAEWP. So these are the short forms which you will find when you open from your system client ANSYS admin utility. There you will find these short forms, and based on these short forms, you can figure out which license I'm using or you are using. Okay. I think we saw this NLT and NLS. Like professional, you will find this one. NLT, you will find a PRF dot. Like now, there are a few more like ANSYS LS Dyna, similar Dyna. When we talk about structural, you will find structural like this. And when we talk about ANSYS mechanical, you will find ANSYS. So ANSYS structural is also one of the solver which is as more similar to ANSYS mechanical. I think structural is not given here, but you will also find that ANSYS structural, which is more or less similar to ANSYS mechanical. Okay. And this is one of the fastest or growing company. You will find each within a few months there is a version upgrade are there. So ANSYS, that's why it is most widely used software in the world. Now there are like ANSYS Multiphysics, Mechanical, Professional. So these are the your solvers, and for this you will find Multiphysics solver like MPBA, and you will also find MEBA, like it is ANSYS Mechanical Solver, ANSYS Professional Solver, PRBA, ANSYS Structural Solver, STBA, and if it is structural, then you will find structural. Now when we talk about fatigue, you will find D40. When we talk about rigid dynamics, it will find dynamics, and mechanical HPC, you will easily figure out by make HPC. Now there are other physics like electromagnetic EMAC, CFD, as well as CFD preforce, ANSYS ASAS, and there one more thing like for academic. So you will find the separate short forms for academic like AA underscore A. This is basically for academic associate. For academic CFD, you will find like this. Similarly for HPC, you will find like that. And similarly for research, Autodyne, mechanical. So always keep in mind for academic, you will find word AA before your license short form. Okay. So that's it, guys. I think we cover most of the topics what we discuss in our presentation. So here, as we discuss, like what are the types, what are the different products for structure domain. So you can have a look on this ANSYS portal. There you will find the different domains, like other than structural, for embedded, for electronics. Just go through the license, and based on that description or based on your understanding, you can select the respective license. In capability, you can easily download this capability license from Google, and there you can easily find out the from pre-processing to post-processing, thermal, non-linear, which license I need to select or which license is useful. Then also we discuss about the short forms. So as we know that there are different short forms which are available in ANSYS. So based on the short forms, you can easily figure out which license you are using. So that's it, guys. Thank you for your time. Let me know your comments. I'll be there to help you.